The Dallas County District Attorney could spend 180 days in jail. The judge in the Amber Geiger trial is going after John Creuzot for breaking a gag order that she imposed. It's not only an unusual legal situation, but some people think politics are also at play here. And one guy who can talk about both of these is Dallas attorney Victor Vitals. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you.
Creuzot was not the attorney of record. He did not divulge anything of substance in this TV interview on the eve before the Amber Geiger trial. Why in the world is the judge going after him?
This is a very interesting scenario. I've been practicing law for 25 years. I don't think I've ever seen anything like this. What is remarkable is what you're highlighting. You have two office holders from the same party duking it out in the courts.
Well, let's talk about that, because this is Democrat on Democrat.
Right.
And some people have told me the chatter out there is that Tammy Kemp might want to run for district attorney sometimes. Regardless of that, is it really good for the party? I'm sure the Republicans would love to have that seat back that John Creuzot is in.
Yeah, you're right about that. It is an interesting scenario. Again, I've not seen this scenario. I've not heard what you've heard about her aspiring to that office, but perhaps that's what happens when you have a county that is dominated by one party. The route to various offices has to be through your fellow Democrat, or when it was Republicans running the county, you have the same scenario.
What's worst case scenario for John Creuzot if he's convicted on this?
Well, what's interesting is the man who is responsible for enforcing the law could himself find himself on the wrong end of the law and sentenced to jail time. So it's a dangerous situation for John Creuzot. Criminal contempt.
Dangerous.
Is absolutely.
That's not overstating it?
It's not overstating it. Would you want to sit in jail?
Absolutely not.
So that's why it's dangerous. And not only is it dangerous because who wants to sit in jail, but it's dangerous because he is the man responsible for enforcing the law. Obviously, his answer is the gag order that I'm accused of violating is unconstitutional, number one. And number two, he's saying, even if it's not unconstitutional, the plain letter of the gag order was not violated by the plain vanilla remarks that I made.
But haven't courts said the gag orders are constitutional?
It depends on the situation. It depends if they're necessary. This one, if you're asking my opinion, probably is constitutional. The real question is, did John Creuzot violate it?
Do you see any way that the sitting district attorney is sent to jail by a sitting judge of the same party in this county?
Well, the operative decision is going to be made by Tammy Kemp, unless she's recused. And of course, John Creuzot is saying, you're biased against me. So the first question, Jason, is should she be removed from deciding the question? If she is removed from deciding the question, my own view is another judge sitting in judgment of this probably will not find John Creuzot in contempt.
And final moments, if you were representing John Creuzot, I know you're not, but if you were in this case, what would his defense be?
His defense is, I didn't violate the gag order. My remarks were plain vanilla remarks, and they did not prohibit me from saying what I said.
All right. Victor Vitals, good to see you again. Thank you.
Thank you.